but I didn't want to lose that way. I worked too hard for it.
Did you talk to him afterwards?
Yeah, I mean, I've been talking before. We're cool buddies, you know what I'm saying? But buddies are not 100,000 euro dudes, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Exactly.
How do you feel, you know, fatigue-wise, body-wise, just, you know, going back-to-back, two different opponents, two different styles? We knew what John was going to bring. He actually is a kickboxer. So from going to the first matchup to this matchup, going through your head, how did you feel?
I wasn't in my best in that first match at all. And my timing was way off. I was having like a whole, you know, an acid buildup in my muscles.
Muscle fatigue.
I just wasn't myself. I knew I should have did much better against Rex, but I couldn't. I couldn't. My body and my mind wasn't in sync. With John though, things started to flow a little bit easier. I just decided to let the fight come to me, and that's exactly what it did. I caught him with a couple of flush knees in his head legally. That really hurt him. He's a tough guy. Anybody else would have got the hell out of there. You know, I could see his eyes rolling back, but he was like, no, I'm not going away. I'm not giving up. I'm still here to fight. So I would have had to knock him out unconscious. He was ready to stay and brawl. But when he saw that opportunity to take that W and get the hell out of here, he went for it.
Was it strange feeling entering the cage for the second time in one night?
Super strange. Super strange, super difficult. And I'm ready for it next year. I mean, now that I have an idea better of how to deal with the emotional ride, the roller coaster, beyond that last thing, that was a roller coaster I never met. You never saw somebody get robbed of $100,000 in front of national television. But, you know, it's a messed up feeling for a small fraction.
What was going through your head mentally, like emotionally,
honestly,
everything?
Because the last PFL, Steven Seilock, if he was, got a caught for the upkick.
That was the last one.
And he, you know, said he couldn't continue, et cetera, and won and made it to the final. I'm like, this is not happening. And the crazy part is, he was sitting directly behind my corner. So as I look to my corner, I see, so I'm like, no, this is that. No. You know, deja vu. So I just wanted to get the hell out of there, get to my closet and go, you know, unleash my emotions. And Carlos and Ray said, sit your monkey ass down. And they ain't say that. But they told me, go sit down and we're going to figure this thing out. We're going to do this the right way and the PFL way. And I thank them for that.
When they raised your arm, what was your emotion?
First one? It took so long. I didn't have a clue. I thought I lost. I didn't know what. Then they said draw. Then they went to, they told me how we won because of the first round. It was crazy. I mean, the fans, I'm sure, ready for the next fights. But this DC crowd, man, I love it. Every time I'm here, they give me so much feedback.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking I've got a second home here. I want to, next year, after New York, they better bring me back here.
We're going to count on that.
I want to be back.
You know, because the last time you
was, last time
you was here,
we had a 10-piece spice.
Right. We sure did. We had a good snack in the locker room.
Yeah.
But the last time you was here, you was like, look, I belong on TV. I belong on that main event.
Yes, sir.
You was kind of salty about being on the Facebook card. So now that you got a chance to expose yourself twice, mentally for a fighter, that improved. Just like, hey, the world is seeing all the hard work I'm putting at the gym. You know, aside, nothing against Facebook, but you know, you want to be on that too.
Yeah, I mean, you get more sponsors, et cetera, et cetera. People want to, they want to line your pocketbook. So it costs a little bit more not to be on Facebook, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Anything else?
Yeah, I was going to say, you ran out of the cage and kind of thought it was over.
How
sure were you that it was basically done for you?
I thought it was done because me and Howard had hugged. They left, said, you know, I saw 3-4 people, it's over, it's done. I thought it was done. I thought that was it. I thought I lost that 100 and whatever thousand, my chance at a million. And I'm like, not like this. You know what I'm saying? Not after busting up one of the greatest fighters, you know, for 2 rounds. And not like that. You know what I'm saying? That's not the way you want to lose. You know, let me lose. Let me wake up and lose. Let me do any other way. Not like that.
Yeah, I know. Everybody knows, you know, what your plans is, you know, if everything is tied to prize route, everything you're tied to Chicago and what you're trying to do for the community.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I don't think that gets highlighted enough.
No, I mean, I need that because, again, Chicago's standing behind me tonight. When they see $1 million, they start paying more attention to you, but they ain't getting it. but they there, and like you said, money holds weight. And winning this million, I help people listen. I help me get more of these guys who just believe there's no other way besides shooting somebody every time you have a dispute to have a conversation. To maybe, you know what, my homie Boo would bring us in the gym and we can go box you or whatever. I don't care how it is, just stop shooting each other. That's all I want.
Well, more or less, Lewis, where I'm going at that, I've been to Chi-Raq, a couple times, and I know the appeal, especially with African Americans in MMA. So yes, that tone needs to change a little bit. Do you feel like you can be the voice and the answer to that?
So. They've watched me in a movement, but they haven't saw the financial success. So without the financial success, they're like, he fight, but he ain't got no Lambo. You know what I'm saying? So, but anyway, I never have a Lambo. But anyway, even if I had the money, but now when I go back and when I succeed, when I hopefully win this million. And say I want to do a marathon for Put the Guns Down, I'm sure people are going to line up. When I say I want to do a bike ride for Put the Guns Down, people are going to line up. You know, these things are going to happen. And sometimes it takes not disappointing someone else not to pull the trigger, not to just go, you know what, he'd be so mad at me if I did that. And that's all I want. I just want them to know that I love them and I don't want them to do the dumb shit that everybody else does.
Yeah, look, is anybody else from Chicago, celebrity athletes, they found out about your cause. Your followers did go up while I was watching that. So I was just wanted to ask, everybody knows about your cause. Is anybody, celebrities, performance-wise, MMA, boxing-wise, or just want to continue to help out your cause when you reach
out? Not necessarily, but I associate myself a lot with Bilal Muhammad, and we've been having some conversations with some people who Mike can open the doors on different causes, and we're gonna get this thing rolling. We're gonna be better for our community.
Absolutely, appreciate it, man.
What's that?
Yeah.
Thank you, fellas. Right. I'll be smooth.
Must see TV.
My hand sore as heck. I wish. I'm an elbow.